Today I'm going to show you how to create a paint bucket mockup in Adobe Photoshop. First, open your Quick Selection tool from the toolbar. And click and drag over the bucket to select it. Press Ctrl+J to cut the image from its background. Double-click on this and rename it Paint Bucket Body. Press Ctrl+J to duplicate. And rename it Shadow and Highlights. Disable the layer. Select the layer below. Open your rectangle tool from the toolbar. And draw a rectangle. Click the fill. And select any color for shape. Right-click and convert it to Smart Object. And then decrease the opacity. Press Ctrl+T to free transform. Right-click and choose the distort. Click and drag of the corner handles. Right-click again, and choose Warp. Then use these handles to distort the shape and match it to your bucket body. Hit Enter once you're satisfied. Set the opacity back to 100%. Then right-click and create Clipping Mask. Double-click on this, and rename it, Your Image. Let's place the image of the paint bucket by double-clicking on the thumbnail. Go to File. Place Embedded. And place your design. Adjust the size and position. Hit Enter when you're finished. Go back to File. And choose Save. Let's come back to our image. Change the blend mode of this layer from normal to linear burn. Click the FX icon and choose the blending options. Hold the Alt key to split the black slider of the underlying layer. Click OK once you're satisfied. Go to Filter. Blur. And Gaussian Blur. Increase the radius to 2 pixels. Now enable the top layer. Then right-click and create Clipping Mask. Change the blend mode from normal to soft light. I'll decrease the opacity to 35%. Select the three layers by holding down Shift key. Press Ctrl+G to place them into a folder group. Name the group layer, Design. Disable the group layer. Select the background. Open your Object Selection tool from the toolbar. Open the mode at the top and select Lasso. Make a loose selection of the areas which are covering the bucket. Enable the group layer. Then create a layer mask. Press Ctrl+I to invert. And that's it. Hope you liked it.